say, what's good? You see, most of the relationships do break up because of this different tribe and different religious background. Mami Musa, be a wish you are wonderful. Oye, Asantini, or no social food, the Volta region. Or the neighbor, fear, mama, ne papa so mum penis because of free Volta region. Ebasa, untrim fat parents, ne son ko worry. And answer also would tear parents, the no jar worry.
Thank you very much. Life is about choices. Okay. And so, would you want to choose someone you don't know against your parents you have been with probably for the last 25 years? It's a choice. Secondly, why are your parents insisting that they do not want you to marry from that tribe? You should get to know why. Love is not static.
It's dynamic.
You see, I have always wondered when people consistently say with passion, I love him, without him I can't live, without her I can't live.
I can't breathe.
That's neither here nor there. Because you have lived probably 25 years without seeing that person, and you are there. If the person you love today dies, you still love another person.
Another person.
In fact, some people has as much as 5 or 6 lovers.
No, of course.
And they're able to survive. I hope you are getting me. So love is not static to one person. Some people will tell me, well, the Bible said God took the rib of a woman, and so every man has one wife. Who told you that woman is your wife? People would generally say, nyami and yachel, nyami and yifinja.
Or shall we them and yaw dia?
Oh, people
I'm outside,
yeah. I hope you are getting me.
Yeah,
and so if your parents are insisting, I would rather wish you would sit your parents down, discuss it with them. Probably the reason they are giving you is tangible. So for me, it's the choice.
Okay.
It's the choice.
Okay.
Because if I marry today, it is not my parents who is going to do anything for me in the marriage. They can help me pay the bride price of the woman, probably some aspects of it. But if you are a man and you are not ready to pay a woman's bride price with your own hard-earned money, then you are not even ready to marry. Okay? And so if you think that your parents' words, your parents' advice are not tangible enough, you can decide to defy their advice, which will be a consequence on your own head. So it's the choice.
It's a choice, okay. Now let's look at the consequences in tribal, intertribal and interreligious marriages. Yeah, where, you see, the two partners are coming from different backgrounds.
Yes.
The way they were brought up were different. And so when they are into a relationship, how come they are able to adjust in order for the relationship to move on smoothly?
When you talk about adjustment, I have said earlier on, if you want to go into an intertribal or interreligious marriage. Then you should be a level-headed person.
Okay.
It is only level-headed people who are able to adjust to issues of life.
Okay.
There are some people, they are so strict and rigid that once my religion says this,
you follow. Okay.
That is it. Okay. And so there are so many problems that we come with intertribal, interreligious. Let's first of all talk about interreligion. Probably you are a Muslim and then you go to marry a Christian, for instance. Now, Muslims are to pray 5 times
a day.
They use the kettle, which we normally call the buta.
They
use a lot of things. Okay. Maybe you are a Methodist. You go to your church on Sundays alone. Now, you give birth to children. Probably you have been able to acquaint yourself. We now give birth to 2 children. I am a Muslim. You are a Christian and you are my wife. You want to go to church with my children on Sunday.
On Sunday.
I want to go to the mosque with my children on Fridays. Who decides for the children?
This is a serious issue.
Do you get that? So this is where the problem
lies.
Begins.
Okay.
If it is for the two of you, you may be fine. Now, as a Christian woman, probably it's Friday night, I'm going for all night. Muslims don't go for all night.
No,
so you are my wife. Every Friday night, instead of staying with me, you are going for all night.
Then I think you have to come to an agreement.
Do you get me?
So it takes a mature couple.
That's what I said, the level-headed persons. So if you are not level-headed, don't venture into an inter-tribal or an inter-religious relationship or marry. And so to me, I've always said, the moment you meet a lady and you ask, you want her, she's so beautiful. She's not the only beautiful person.
No, of course.
There are so many beautiful women.
So she's learned.
She's not the only learned person.
Oh, of course.
I hope you're getting me. She's industrious. She's not the only industrious person. And so you ask her name, what's your name? And she tells you, I'm Eva. The next question is, Eva what?
Eva what?
Because it is the same name that will make you decide where the person come from. Probably you need to even ask, where do you come from? Okay. Recently I was reading something on social media. The guy changed his name. That is an Ashanti. Not knowing he's from the northern region. He got some Ashanti elderly men. They came to marry the lady.
Wow.
And after 2-3 years, he said the father is dead, and so they should go for funeral. They have driven her, he mentioned some town's name.
In the northern region?
Straight. And then the lady asked, so you are not
now? Yeah, not now. And he said,
to me,
you are Awaje or Esi.
You get me.
Okay.
So now can I say, when they gave birth to him, the father was living in Ashanti, so they named him after the landlord who had been good to them. And so the lady said, you have lied. And that was the end of the marriage.
I think because of stigmatization.
Do you get me?
Because
people wouldn't want you to say, my husband is this, my wife.
Region.
Do you get me?
So
there are nothingness who don't want Ashantis. There are Ashantis who don't want nothingness. And it's everywhere. And so there are so many consequences. In Ghana, there are basically two inheritance systems, the matrilineal
and then the patrilineal
inheritance.
Mm-hmm.
Some tribes do the patrilineal inheritance, some tribes do the matrilineal. And so if you are an Ashanti, you are a Bono, you are an Akan, Fantis, they all do the matrilineal inheritance. The Votarians, the Northerners, they do the patrilineal inheritance. Now, if you miss this tribal through marriage, where are your children going to inherit from? Is it from the mom? Which they will go to their uncles.
Okay.
You get me?
Or
from the father himself. I hope you are getting that. These are some of the problems that might crop up during. I remember growing up, I had a friend, a very good friend. In fact, we thought of maybe we could end up in marriage. And she was a Sabbath, I was a charismatic then. And anytime we moved together, probably sometimes we'd be passing by a football field. And when people were praying in tongues, then she'll be laughing. She said, look at these mad people.
Because she's an Adventist.
Do you get me? She can't fathom why people should make that kind of
noise.
And so if you go into marriage with this kind of lady and you pray in tongues in your room, what do you think will happen?
Probably the woman will walk out.
You're making too much noise in the house.
Of course.
Okay. And I said, when love is fresh, you don't see the faults. But as you stay for a while, every little thing, sometimes if you don't take time, become a problem for you. And so, to me, it will be better if you choose people from your own tribe and from your own religious settings, rather than going into other tribes or other religions. But then, if you are a level-headed person like myself, then you can go all out for anybody you want to choose.
So what tribe are you coming from?
I am Ebonyi.
And your wife?
She's also Ebonyi.
Okay, so for you, you didn't have any tough time?
No, there wasn't.
Oh, that, all right.
That problem from the same constituency.
No, so okay, so let me ask probably the last but one question. Aside marrying from the same tribe or from the same religious background, you see the way the two partners were brought up, they celebrate birthday occasions, they go out. Now, mother worry. Not familiar with that. Obaneso is familiar with that. So when this happens now, a blue birthday now, Berman for 1 pound, it becomes a problem in the house. And Ebasa, Mimuni say, even say Ube choose say Ube worry from the same tribe, you know. Yeah, the background and I said the way I upbringing the two partners, you know, is really important.
And that's very true.
Mm.
You see, I heard a story of a married couple, the guy from a village and the lady a city dweller. And so, you know, those days growing up, the paste we used was manzan. I hope if you are not that mature, so you may not know manzan.
Pepsodent.
Manzan had a very thick cover. Okay, it's not like the Pepsodent today that you can press anywhere and the paste will come out. So Mazam, you start from there,
the bottom. Okay.
And so that's how the guy is used to. So any place he picks, he starts from the bottom. The lady has been using close-up and Pepsodent, which have a very soft cover. And so the first day of marriage, the following morning, the guy picks the paste and pressed
from the bottom.
A new paste they had bought. Then the lady pressed the neck.
The neck of
the then the guy was angry. Why have you pressed? This thing generated into a very great fight, which nearly collapsed their friendship. Yeah. So our backgrounds are very, very important in marriage. As you're saying, there are people who celebrate birthday. Some of us, even the day you forget that it's your birthday. So if you marry a woman who have been celebrating birthdays from day one. Yesterday I saw Onyema Awoyeje buying a car, a customized car for her son, 1 year boy. So you see this guy at age one have had a car as a birthday
as
present.
A birthday present.
Some of us have not even gotten an egg an before egg. For a birthday present. So if you go to marry this
guy,
and you are from the hinterland who have never celebrated the birthday, it may end up being a problem for you because he will wish you will celebrate his birthday for him, but then you have never done that to yourself. And so there are so many dynamics, but I have always said marriage is a very complex institution. And so people, most of the time, pastors will counsel you before you marry.
Before you marry.
What happens after marriage?
After marriage.
When problem arises, what happens? But I have always said again that it is not always proper to go out and sell what's in your marriage. Because for all you know, what you're telling the pastor, what is in his home, is even worse
than yours.
Your own. And so it will be proper to be level-headed. It will be proper to have a continuous learning on how to live well with your partner, and you have a successful marriage.
All right, thank you very much. Unfortunately, our time will not permit us to continue, but I believe next time we shall meet talk about this because it is really a trending issue that we need to address. Thank you very much, Sir Bosco. All right, lovely viewers. He is a lecturer from St. Monica's College of Education. I believe you've learned so many things from his delivery, and then you make the right decision or the right choice. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to our social media handles on Ideas That I Don't Know Multimedia. So say your final words.
All right, thank you very much once again. It's been a pleasure being on your show.
You're welcome.
I believe it will not be the last time.
No.
My advice to the youth, if you have not chosen a spouse yet, if you want to choose,
choose wisely. Don't only rely on love, because it is a complex thing which so many of us still do not understand. And so choose someone you can be with for the rest of your life. Ask yourself, can I stay in the same room with this person for the next 40 years? Probably you are 20, so you may live for 60. So you are going to be with a person for the next 40 years of your life. And so if you want to choose, take your time and choose wisely. Listen to the counsel of your parents and the elderly before you make a choice of a life partner. On that note, I wish our viewers a very lovely day, and I hope they will also share and like the page. Thank you very much.
All right, you're welcome. Thank you once again. All right, you're welcome. So that is it. Make the right decision, because you're going to stay with your partner for the next 40, 50 years. That is where I'll leave you. See you same time next week. Bye-bye. The name still remains Eva Esiedua Inshaba. To all my lovely fans out there, especially my fans are more Italy, ti amo tanto. Ciao, ciao.